पैनिक डिसऑर्डर, पैनिक डिसऑर्डर, पैनिक डिसऑर्डर इज डिफाइंड बाय द प्रेजेंस ऑफ रिकरेंट एंड अनप्रेडिक्टेबल पैनिक अटैक्स. दिस पैनिक अटैक्स इज ए डिस्टिंक्ट एपिसोड ऑफ इंटेंस फियर एंड डिसकम्फर्ट. द पैनिक डिसऑर्डर इज डिफाइंड बाय द प्रेजेंस ऑफ रिकरेंट एंड अनप्रेडिक्टेबल पैनिक अटैक्स. देयर इज रिकरेंट एंड अनप्रेडिक्टेबल पैनिक अटैक, बट दिस पैनिक अटैक इज रिकरेंट अटैक, रिकरेंट. इन द पैनिक डिसऑर्डर देयर इज रिकरेंट पैनिक अटैक एंड इंटेंस फियर, देयर इज इंटेंस फियर. This is the recurrent attack, and the patient feel discomfort. Patient feel discomfort because of this panic attacks, and the intense fear and discomfort in the panic attack. And these intense fear and discomfort are associated with variety of physical symptoms. The physical symptoms include palpitation, sweating, trembling. The physical symptoms include palpitation, sweating, tingling. There is palpitation, sweating, and tingling in the panic disorders. Sometimes there is chest pain. Sometimes there is chest pain. The patient feel heaviness in the chest. Dizziness and fear is the symptoms. Dizziness may occur in the panic disorders. The fear is the prominent symptoms. There is fear. The panic attacks, the prominent symptoms is the fear. Paresthesia, gastrointestinal distress, and feeling of unhealthy are also common. There is paresthesia. Feeling of unhealthy, paresthesia, feeling of unhealthy GI symptoms. The GI symptoms may begin in cases of the panic disorders. The acute panic attacks is the sudden attacks that resolve within 10 minutes. Acute panic attack is the attack that resolves spontaneously within 10 minutes. Within 10 minutes of attack. In the panic disorders, the patient is sensitive. The patient is sensitive. They may be sensitive to place, or time, or they may be sensitive to person. Sometimes the acute panic attack patient escape. The patient want to escape from that situation, from that situations. The best treatment to desensitize the patient. The best treatment is to desensitize the patient. And there is cognitive behavioral therapy for the acute, but in 70% of the panic disorders there may be major depressive disorders. The patient may escape from the place. Anxiety develops over time and results in a generalized fear. Anxiety develops in acute panic disorder. Anxiety may develop, anxiety may develop, and patient present is a fear, palpitations. They show avoidance of a place or situation in which panic attacks might reoccur. Irrational fear of being in the place where one might feel fearful, and the patient want to escape from that place. Sometimes the panic disorders, panic attack is not present, and the patient feels that if he or she goes to that place, the panic attack may occur. In the panic attack, patient become embraced. The patient in the panic attack, they become embraced. And they become housebound. They become housebound because if they go to a particular place or situations or gathering, the panic attack may occur. So the patients are restricted to a home, they become a housebound or they embraced like the bird in a cage. Because of the panic attack. The panic attack is so disturbing because it can cause fear, palpitations, sweating, dizziness. Sometimes the panic attack occurs when the patient is waking from sleep or patient walking to a particular situation. There is dizziness, palpitation, sweating may occur and disturb the patient's life. What is the differential diagnosis DD for the panic disorders? The diagnosis of the panic disorder is made a variety of cardiovascular, respiratory, endocrine and neurological condition must be excluded if there is panic disorders. We special focus on a specific feature of the panic disorder. For example, 20% of patients who present with syncope have a primary medical complaint. They show the diagnosis of mood and anxiety disorder. 20% of people of present with syncope, they have panic disorder, acute panic attack, and they have panic disorder. 20% of patients of syncope, they have bipolar disorder, mood disorder. They have the mood disorders. The differential diagnosis of the panic disorder is complicated by high rate of comorbidity with other psychiatric condition, especially if the patient is alcoholic, if the patient is addictive, and in the patient take benzodiazepine abuse, they may comorbidity. If the patient take of benzodiazepine abuse or alcohol abuse because of the problem in the mood. This is the comorbidity sign. Sometimes the acute panic attack may occur with other disease. They associated with other disease. These diseases include pheochromocytoma, thyrotoxicosis, and hypoglycemia. Sometimes the acute panic attack symptoms may occur with the thyrotoxicosis. Because thyrotoxicosis, the thyroid hormones increase in the heart rate increase, there may be syncope, palpitation, sweating. Pheochromocytoma can also cause the symptom like acute panic attack. Pheochromocytoma can also cause the symptom like acute panic attack. Hypoglycemia sometimes the symptom is like the acute panic attack. There is three diseases: pheochromocytoma, thyrotoxicosis, hypoglycemia. Because these conditions, pheochromocytoma, thyrotoxicosis cause tachycardia. There is other two diseases, that is paroxysmal atrial tachycardia. Paroxysmal atrial tachycardia can also the same symptom of acute panic attack. They increase the heart rate. The mitral valve prolapse can also increase the heart rate and the symptom like acute panic attack. The symptom is like acute panic attack. 43% of patients with chest pain who had normally coronary angiogram is present is a complaint of panic attack. 43% of the patient who complain of chest pain, there is acute panic attack, but this patient has normal coronary angiogram and their chest pain is due to the acute panic attack. And 9% of all these patients refer to the cardiac evaluation. And on other side, they have no cardiac evaluation, they have acute panic attack. What is the etiology of the acute panic attack? The acute panic attack etiology is unknown, but it appears to involve a genetic predisposition. There is genetic predisposition of the acute panic attack. There is also social learning. The panic attack shows familial aggregation. There is the familial aggregation in case of the panic disorders. If panic disorder is, the etiology is unknown, genetic predispositions, and this is familial aggregations. 30-45% of the monozygotic twins has the disorder. 30-45% of cases, the monozygotic twin has the predisposition to the acute panic attack. That is 30-45% of the monozygotic twins have the predisposition to the attack of acute panic attack. And there is also a genome-wide screen they have identified. It suggests that there is specific loci which is risk for the transmissions of the acute panic attack disorders. There is loci, the wide genome association and genome-wide association study suggests that there is loci, locus, specific position on the genes that have transmit these abnormal allele to the next generation, and this responsible for the acute panic attack. This is responsible for the acute panic attack. The interesting thing is that the infusion of sodium lactate can evolve an attack in 2/3 of the panic disorder. The infusions of sodium lactate. If you infuse sodium lactate, two to three times, there is the risk for the acute panic attack. By the infusing the sodium lactate infusion. Carbon dioxide inhalation can also cause the acute panic attack. Carbon dioxide inhalation can also cause the acute panic attack. And the alpha adrenergic antagonists, that is called cholecystokinin 4. When we take cholecystokinin 4, it can also cause acute panic attack. There is a hypothesis. They state that each stimulus that activates the non-adrenergic neuron in the locus coeruleus in the dorsal raphe nucleus can also cause the acute panic attack. This hypothesis states that each stimulus that activates the locus coeruleus, this locus coeruleus can activate the raphe nucleus. When raphe nucleus activated, it can also cause acute panic attack. Because the locus coeruleus activate the raphe nucleus, this causes acute panic attack. When this acute panic attack occur, in this case, there is medial temporal lobe abnormalities, because the medial temporal lobe with greater activation occur. When the locus coeruleus stimulation occur, it stimulates the raphe nucleus. There is acute panic attack in the medial temporal lobe, activation and excitations occur. This is the hypothesis, not the true story. When the medial temporal lobe activation occur, this activate the amygdala frontal, this also activate the amygdala. When this the medial temporal lobe activate, this activates the amygdala. This activate the amygdala. When the amygdala are activated, so the activation of amygdala, there is delta frontal activation occur. When the delta frontal activation occur in the amygdala, this stimulates the anxiety center. Anxiety center and anxiety develop, and this anxiety is called anxiety disorders, and this is acute panic attack occur. But this is hypothesis. When the anxiety systems develops, there is arousal of the panic attack. Arousal of panic attack occur because of the stimulation of the delta frontal amygdala. The dental frontal amygdala activated because of the medial temporal lobe activation. The medial temporal lobe activation occur because of the locus coeruleus activate the raphe nucleus, and the acute anxiety attack occur. Now we will discuss the treatment of the panic disorder. What is the treatment of panic disorders? How will you manage the patient of the panic disorders? Because the panic disorders, there is pain, palpitations, fear, escape from the place and gathering. The patient is so disturbing. How will we manage this patient? The achievable goals of treatment is to decrease the frequency of panic attack. The goal of treatment is to decrease the frequency and severity of panic attacks, because sometimes there is meaningful gathering and the panic attack occur in a patient, and the patient escape from that situations that cannot compete. Sometimes in the exam, the acute panic attack can also occur. So the goal is to desensitize the patient and decrease the frequency of panic attack to reduce the intensity of the panic attacks. The treatment is the antidepressant. Antidepressant is the ministry of treatment in the panic attack. By the antidepressant, we can desensitize the patient and we develop the confidence in a patient. The normally recommended antidepressant include fluoxetine, paroxetine, sertraline, SNRI, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor. But the side effect of this SSRI is it decreases the libido and it causes sexual dysfunction. It is not good for young one. It causes sexual dysfunction, erectile dysfunction in men. This is not good for young person. Venlafaxine is also, we can recommend venlafaxine. Venlafaxine can also be recommended. This is FDA approved drug. Normally, for the acute panic attack, we prescribe fluoxetine 5 to 10 mg. Fluoxetine 5 to 10 mg. 5 to 10 mg fluoxetine. Sertraline 25 to 50 mg. Sertraline 25 to 50 mg. Sertraline we can also prescribe. Sertraline 25 to 50 mg. Paroxetine by 10 mg. Paroxetine 10 mg. We can prescribe the paroxetine 10 mg. Venlafaxine 37.5 mg. Venlafaxine by 37.5 mg. We can prescribe. The monoamine oxidase inhibitor are also effective. The monoamine oxidase MAO inhibitor can also be effective in the treatment of acute panic attack, but we usually not recommended these MAOI inhibitor because there is side effect of the MAOI inhibitor that include atypical depression. The side effect of MAOI include atypical depression. Atypical depression because of monoamine oxidase inhibitor, atypical depression can develop. Hypersomnia can also develop. Hypersomnia can also develop because of the MAOI inhibitor. Weight gain is another side effect of the monoamine oxidase inhibitor. They can cause weight gain. So we cannot recommend these to the weight gain patient or major depressive disorder patient. The monoamine oxidase inhibitor, we can take this medication with a low tyramine diet. We give these to low tyramine diet. We advise to the patient to eat low tyramine diet because the high tyramine diet contains and include cheese and wine. The cheese and wine contains more amount of the tyramine. Cheese and wine, they contain the much and more amount of tyramine. So we do the low tyramine diet. The antidepressant typically takes for 2 to 6 weeks. These antidepressant, fluoxetine 5 to 10 mg, paroxetine 10 mg, sertraline 25 to 50 mg, SSRI, venlafaxine 27.5 mg. We can prescribe these drugs for 2 to 6 weeks because these antidepressant drug work in weeks, not in days. 2 to 6 weeks to become effective, we do 2 to 6 weeks. We can prescribe these drugs in 2 to 6 weeks. Another drug can also be prescribed, that is benzodiazepine. It is also useful in the early course of the treatment. The benzo is useful in the early course, not the late course. Early course, it include aripiprazolam and clonazepam. They are better tolerated by the patient, especially the short term are better tolerated by the patient. Short acting are better tolerated by the patient. We can also give the Dual proix sodium can also be prescribed. Dual proix sodium can also be prescribed by the doctor to the acute panic attack patient. Pendolol can also be prescribed. Normally, we can prescribe these medication and change these medications sometimes with alternative. 12 to 15 sessions visits are needed. 12 to 15 sessions of visits of the patients are needed to become desensitized the acute panic attacks and 75 to 85% of these patients, we recommended the medication for 1 to 2 years. We recommend these medication in 75 to 80% of the patient for 1 to 2 years, because we want to desensitize the patient completely, and this is for long treatment, long therapy, and we want to desensitize the patient completely. If there is, we should avoid the relapses of the symptoms. So 75 to 80% of the patient needed 1 to 2 years of the treatment, and 12 to 15 sessions of visits to the psychiatrist clinic, are needed for the permanent treatment of the panic attacks. If there is other major depressive disorder like bipolar disorders and other disorder, bipolar 1 and 2, the lithium sometimes may be recommended for the major depressive disorder, but in case of the panic disorders, these medication are and these management is sufficient.